Le Corbusier is no more. Here in his former studio, his life's work is assembled. He made no concession at the outset of his career and was frustrated during the war years. So Le Corbusier waited until he was almost 60 to realize the important conceptions which he had evolved in his youth. In numerous books and articles, he repeatedly expressed his tastes and beliefs, and he made his point so firmly that up to the moment of his death in 1965, when he was almost 80, Le Corbusier remained the center of heated controversies. He was born in Switzerland in 1887, the year when the Eiffel Tower was built, under the name of Charles Edouard Jeanneret. His first experience of art was as decoration. He found no satisfaction in that and looked to other fields for discoveries. The mosques of Turkey first taught him to understand the molding of interior space. He spent 3 weeks on the Acropolis, studying its proportions. He was never to forget it. In 1917, he settled in Paris. Reacting against cubism, which seemed to him too decorative, Le Corbusier created, with the painter aux enfants, the style known as purism. He was fascinated by the researches of those artists and architects who were liberating space. He was not yet producing work of his own, but he knew how to look. He was convinced and then set about convincing others. He founded a review called L'Esprit Nouveau, The New Spirit. He had found a new enthusiasm. He gave himself a new name, Le Corbusier. The Architect. He was fascinated by his own time and its new technical possibilities. He wrote, "To want to fly like a bird was to misconceive the problem. The right way to go about it was to invent a flying machine without thinking about anything except pure mechanics." Let's shut our eyes to everything else and face the problem of designing a machine to live in. And he came up with the solution of making buildings out of a series of standardized elements, which could be combined in different ways. The basis was a concrete framework. Interior walls, which had no supporting function, could then be placed at will, while doors, windows, closets, all prefabricated, could be equally freely disposed. It was a foretaste of modern production methods. But how were Le Corbusier's ideas received by society? In 1925, despite opposition, he used these methods in building 51 small houses near Bordeaux. But their unfamiliar look caused the occupants to alter them. Le Corbusier's only comment was, "Life is always right." From that time on, untreated concrete became the hallmark of his architecture. There is no mistaking the overthrow of classical aesthetic principles. But the new plastic language simply grew out of new technical possibilities. Buildings on piles. Free facades. Swiss students' dormitory, Paris University. Architectural promenade. Salvation Army Hostel, Paris, constructed 1929 to 1931. Free plan. Brazilian students' dormitory, Paris University, constructed 1957 to 1959. Sunbreakers. Roof Terrace, Marseille apartment block, constructed 1947 to 1952. The purest expression of Le Corbusier's theories, his most enjoyable architectural promenade, is the Villa Savoye at Poissy in the suburbs of Paris, built in 1929. Today, the Villa Savoye is one of France's historic monuments. On the other side of the world, in India, and towards the end of his life in 1954, Le Corbusier gave a brilliant illustration of his theory of sunbreakers in the mill owner's building at Ahmedabad, completed in 1956. The Chauxde House at Ahmedabad, a stunning complex of interlocking volumes beneath a parasol roof, offers a variation in the use of sunbreakers. Another example of open structure, the Sarabhai House at Ahmedabad, also completed in 1956. Thank you. In a park in Zurich stands the Heidi Weber Museum, a striking polychrome structure which was Le Corbusier's last work. The Sociologist. For Le Corbusier, a house, no matter how beautiful, had little significance in itself. What counted for him was the interrelationship between the dwelling, its use for work, and its possibilities for leisure. He was concerned with urbanized man. Freedom for the individual. That is to say, space, sunlight, and open green areas for each and all of us. In 1942, he invented a scale of measurement based on human proportions, the modulor. Previously written, primitive man used to measure by the length of his face, his forearm, or his thumb. Le Corbusier decided to base all his architectural calculations on the requirements of a 6-foot man. At the age of 60 in 1947, he undertook his first great work, the apartment block in Marseille. Each apartment is designed on 2 levels. They all look out in 2 directions, east and west. Light is everywhere. A balcony gives each apartment an extension outside. It also gives shade in summer, but lets in light in winter when the sun is on its lowest course. But when this building was completed, a suit was brought against Le Corbusier for defiling the landscape. For 5 years, he worked on this great communal housing project, despite the difficulties of the immediate post-war period, and despite repeated attacks on him in the press. But this imposing edifice ended by imposing its creator on the world. The Marseille block was conceived as one of a group forming the Radiant City. Eight such blocks would have been grouped around a civic center in Saint-Denis in eastern France if Le Corbusier's plan for the reconstruction of this war-ravaged town had been carried out. For many years, Le Corbusier worked on the problem of reclaiming urban space with his cousin, Pierre Jeanneret. Together, they had founded an architectural studio in the Rue de Sèvres in Paris, where among their succession of international collaborators were Sirt, Sakakura, Wojenski, Doshi, also Xenakis, who supervised the building of the monastery of La Tourette near Lyon between 1956 and 1959. Le Corbusier sighted the building atop a steep slope. On the left, the windowless block of the chapel. On the right, the monastery block, lit through slanted frames of glass. The chapel, unsurpassed in its austerity, is a volume of silence.